Earth Day's connection to NASA actually goes back to Christmas Eve in 1968 and this iconic photo.
In that perspective, you can only see from space this fragile blue marble just suspended there in the emptiness of the vastness of space.
NASA's technology chief Douglas Terrier says the agency had the first weather satellites in 1960 and has studied the Earth data for all those years. And scientist Michelle Thaler says that's all in an effort to understand the Earth better.
We can actually see from satellites in space where air pollution is getting worse, where it's actually getting better as we use cleaner technologies. So we have a lot of data now to advise people and also our leadership around the world about how to protect the environment.
And protecting the environment comes from technologies NASA has developed to work in space.
Use the International Space Station is one of the most pressing environments because we've got crews that have been living here for two decades now continuously. They're recycling all the air and all the water because of the obvious cost of, you know, bringing fresh supplies up.
And even today, as the COVID-19 virus spreads, NASA is studying the effect that it is having on the planet.
The Earth system. It's very complicated, very interdependent, but in some ways we see indications that our behavior, if we modify our behavior, we can see good outcomes as well.
Both Terrier and Thaler are encouraged by advancements going forward and in the people living on this third planet from the sun.
And I think the most important thing as we look at Earth Day, and we are certainly in the middle of a crisis right now, so it helps us to remember just how fragile and how precious this lifeboat we have in space.
Dave Manocherry, KCRA 3 News.